And first question is just, how is the campaign going and how are you and the family holding up?
We are doing great. Thank you so much for asking. We're in South Carolina, for all those who don't know that. Fred's thrilled because they cook the beans all the way through here. From the Midwest, where we don't cook the beans as much, and literally he's been complaining since our first day of marriage, and he's thrilled that the food is so good here. We've gained about 5 pounds in the last 2 weeks. So it's actually going really well. The kids are doing great here. The weather's warm. The people are even warmer, and we're really excited about Saturday.
And there are a lot of women who are still undecided in this Republican race in particular. Why do you think your husband would be the best candidate for women in particular?
Well, there's two things, and for all you ladies out there who haven't made a decision, I know exactly what you're talking about. I shop a lot, as much as I can, everywhere I can, and sometimes it takes a long time for me to make a decision, but when I'm ready to make that decision, it's always the right one. And the reason, sorry there's so many people walking by, and the reason that I think y'all ought to think about voting for my husband is because we need someone now who has credibility and authority. The credibility and the honesty to do this for the right reasons. He's not doing this for his resume. He's doing this because he believes that our country needs someone who has the credibility and honesty to go to the American people and say, these are the things we need to do to save our economy, to increase our prosperity, to make sure we preserve our national security. He's 100% right to life. I'm 100% with him. We've got to use that bully pulpit to talk about the values and raising these families the way that we're trying to so hard, you know, despite all the stuff, all the media influences.
Now, speaking of the media, is there something that's not getting across in the media about your husband? Just one thing you'd want women voters to know about him that they might not know yet?
I would want them to know that his big shoulders are actually not just physical, but they're metaphysical. If you look at his record, if you think about all the things he's done in his life, people have called on him, Condoleezza Rice, President Bush, single women with children that knew that their governor was corrupt. He's the one that they went to make sure that they had someone to protect them and fight for them and save them, and that was Fred Thompson. And he's the guy people go to, and he's just a wonderful man.